Hello and welcome to the Penguin Prof channel. I'm Valerie Pennington. I've got a quick bite today. I want to show you an amazing app and how you can make great videos for your classes using your phone. And the app I want to demo is called InShot. And I just want to say that I'm going to show you the free version. If you want to unlock more features, there are paid versions. And if you really like this app, please consider supporting the developers. But there are tons of features available for free. And I just want to show you before we get into the demo here, all of the tools you're going to see on the bottom and just highlight some of them that are really important, like the undo and redo, how you add media to your project, how you can change the aspect ratio of the project. I'm going to show you how to add text, how to do Picture-in-Picture, which is usually a pro feature. Lots of the basics, crop, rotate, flip, but you can also change the speed and add freeze frames. It's really incredible. So let me show you what it looks like. This is my basic setup. It is just a phone on a clamp. You can use a tripod, of course. This was the clamp I got really cheap on Amazon. I'm not even using an external mic here. So I did my main shot this way. And then because I'm actually showing objects, I'm shooting some supplementary footage, and we call this B-roll if you want to be fancy. And you'll see in the video how I use it. Depending on what you're doing, of course, you may or may not need this, but make sure you can hold that phone steady. Okay, here is what InShot looks like. I'm going to make a video. And the first thing you want to do is select from your camera roll the media that you want to import. Click that green check. And this is what it looks like. First thing, you're going to adjust the aspect ratio. Lots of different ones to choose from. 16:9 is the standard for video. You can drag the footage with your finger back and forth. And then the first thing that I do is trim the ends of all my clips. So you just grab the beginning and the end so you can play the video, make sure that it's starting and stopping each clip where you want it to. This is just super easy to do. So with each clip, I'm just going to trim the beginning, the end, when I was grabbing stuff, you know, I want to get rid of all of that. And you can, of course, within a clip, cut and paste. So if you make mistakes and things you want to get rid of, it is literally as easy as using your finger. I don't know what to say. It's just very, very intuitive. You can pinch to zoom the timeline in and out to get more fine detail in your edits. And you can drag and drop to reorder your clips. I'm going to show you how to add text. This is something most educators do a lot. So we've got a lot of text. I always try and put the vocabulary that I'm introducing up on the screen, in addition to the captions, of course. Lots of options with this app, how to make that text stand out. I do recommend that you avoid the fancy stuff, but it is there. Remember, you want to make this as legible as possible. Remember, a lot of your students are going to be watching this on a phone. So think about contrast. So I always use labels, and I like to do black on white. I know it's not that sexy, but it's easy to read, and that's what I care about. And so now I'm going to add another label here just to show you how quick that is. And as soon as you pick a style, then all of your subsequent text will use that default style. So it's really quick to add your text. And then you can treat it like any other object on the timeline. So you can trim it and move it. You can add animations, so it'll change how the text comes on and off the screen. It looks really professional. Transitions are also really easy to do. You get all kinds of basic ones in the free version. That's one of the things in the pro version. You get a lot more options, but you can pick the different ones, see what you like, and then play it through. And yep, that's just perfect. I like simplicity for my transitions. Picture in picture is something that I absolutely love. You can insert video or photos. And then, of course, you can resize them, put them wherever you want. And this is a great way to show details of objects or demos or whatever it is that you're doing without losing your face as well. Here, I'm going to insert another one, and you can do anything. You can rotate them and resize them. This is a free crop, a freehand cropping tool. And that's just going to show exactly the part of the image that I want. And I can resize and put that up there so my students can see it really clearly. And I'm just gonna play through, make sure that it's exactly where I want with respect to everything else. When you're ready to go, you can save it and you can choose different frame rates and different levels of resolution. There are so many options here. It will save automatically to your camera roll, and then you can also share directly with all of these different sites. This is what it looks like.
Exciting from the outside, but on the inside we have this layer which most people know as mother of pearl. It's actually the nacreous layer. This is called nacre. All of this stuff is calcium carbonate, but the way that it's laid down and the other proteins that the animal uses give it this incredible luster and iridescent quality that we love so much.
As always, I hope that was helpful. Thanks so much for visiting the Penguin Prof channel. For more videos like this, check out my EdTech playlist. I'll see you in the next one. Good luck.